MTAR Technologies IPO has opened for subscription today, and here's everything you need to know on whether you must subscribe to this IPO. Well, the Hyderabad-based Precision Engineering Solutions company has launched the IPO today. Now, this public offer will close on the March of 5th. Now, the company has fixed a price band of 574 to 575 rupees per equity share. The IPO is also a fresh issuance of 21.5 lakh equity shares and an offer for sale of up to 82.2 lakh equity shares. Now, the company proposes to utilize the net proceeds from the issue towards the repayment of the borrowings by the company, also for funding the working capital requirements by the company and for general corporate purposes as well. Now, investors can bid for a minimum lot size of 26 shares and in multiples thereof. Now, as for the company financials, the company has grown at 16.5% CAGR over the last 3 years at the top line, while its EBITDA margins were reported at 28.5% in FY20. Now, MTAR has a healthy order book at 1.7 times FY20 revenues and superior profitability ratios as compared to its peers also. Now, in times when the government has been cutting down on the defense budget, we have seen that the company has consistently delivered profits at the bottom line with the net margins at 14% in the last fiscal year. So, should you subscribe to this IPO? Well, here's all the brokerage house's views for you to understand whether you should go for it. Hame Securities has said that MTAR Technologies' financial performance looks quite strong with the healthy balance sheet position as well. Now, the company has a wide product portfolio along with marquee customer base and a robust order book as well for the companies and investors to consider, which actually gives a strong revenue visibility also going forward for the company. Now, the brokerage house has recommended a subscribe rating to this IPO. Jyojit Financial Services believes that MTAR is available at a PE of 47.3 times, which is aggressively priced. It also says that with no listed peers and positive sentiment in the space and the defense sectors due to Make in India and Atmanirbhar Bharat initiatives, and with limited competition for the products that they manufacture, the brokerage house has assigned a subscribe rating with a long-term perspective as well. Samco Securities has said that the company has a good financial track record with a debt to equity of about 0.13 times. However, it says that MTAR is overpriced at an FY20 PE of 57.5 times. On the risk front, it says that the company also derives over 80% of its revenue from its top three customers, leading to the concentration risk. So besides, it does not have any long-term contracts with its clients as well. So keeping the risks in mind, Samco Securities has recommended a subscribe rating to this IPO, but only for listing gains.